Hello everybody, today I'm going to go over real quick how to magnetize a Rhino to also be a Razorback. Here's the top of my kit, already been all done. The Razorback piece, which fortunately comes with the Rhino kit, and the other regular Rhino top hatch, which as you can see, I've glued together into one piece. This is very important. I would definitely recommend doing this well ahead of time and letting the glue cure completely before attempting to magnetize it. Now, what are we going to need for this project? We're going to need a 1/16 inch drill bit or pin vise. I actually don't own a pin vise. I just use a drill bit by hand for plastic. It really is not that big a deal. Magnets, I'm using 1/16 diameter by 1/16 inch thick round rare earth magnets. A hobby knife. Super glue. And a very handy magnetizing tool. This is what I use for my magnetizing. It's got a magnet on each end with the polarities on either side. And what I can do is I stick magnets on one side and the other and put them in different ends. Now, I do want to get this to match up to my other vehicles. There's a Razorback top from one of my other Rhinos. So I want to make sure and get the magnets lined up. See which side is repelling, this side is sticking out. So this is where we're going to want it. Okay, so we want this end, or the pointy end, for the magnets inside the Rhino top. So I'm going to start. Grab our handy dandy drill bit. And we're just going to drill into the top of the Rhino in these little gaps. This makes a great first magnetizing project. Not only is it simple, not requiring any special tools, but you can do it with any Rhino kit because, as I said, the Razorback top comes with the Rhino kit and not with the Razorback kit. And I actually recommend never buying an actual Rhino kit. You'd always buy something else. You can need a Rhino for the extra bits. Whether it be a Razorback or Whirlwind or Razor or whatever. So the hard part I found is not going too deep, but the big magnets on my polarity tool will help with that a lot. And stop the magnets from being sunk too deep. That's going to be useful. If you have a pin vise, of course, this would be a lot easier on your hands, but I've never owned a pin vise and never had a problem just using a drill bit. In fact, that's how I did my entire Tau Army lives by hand. So there are the four holes. They don't have to be perfect. That's nice thing about rare earth magnets. They're really strong. If you have any burrs on the top, just clean those up with a hobby knife or file. So, now for the gluing to the Rhino. This is where the polarity tool really comes in handy, because that way you always know that you have the right polarity. So now that this is stuck there, so the magnet's pointing in the right direction. And a little drop of glue in each one of these holes. It would be nice to test fit them, but I found more often than not that when you test fit them, they don't come back out again. So, I'm just going to take the magnet and stick to the end here. Stick it in the hole. Oops. There we go. Okay, there we go. There's the first one. You want to make sure it's absolutely level. And take the next one. So there we got the four magnets set into the Rhino top. I'm going to go over and wipe off any extra glue. So you don't fill in too bad. I'm putting extra glue in here. keeping your lids from sitting flat. Normally, you can't use a metal knife anywhere near the magnets just after gluing, because otherwise you will have magnets pulling out. But in this case, the magnets aren't that strong compared to the attraction of the super glue, so they actually will stay in there very nicely. Even when working around them with a metal knife. But you have, if you're using bigger magnets, you gotta keep the metal knife away, otherwise it'll just pull it apart. So just real quick, make sure we're at the right magnetizing. Check before we continue. Yeah, I got the polarity right. Put that away. So now we'll move on to the other two parts. This one's easier, so I'm gonna do this one first. So I'm going to have my Razorback on there, just like that. So I'm going to turn it over, and again, we'll just drill four holes into the piece. And again, a little bit open. So, anyway. Okay. So now that we've done, pull it into the Razorback end. Again, I'm just going to put some glue in each hole. Doesn't take very much. Just a little bit of care here will go a long way. The idea is when you put it in the hole, you put it in. Slide it off sideways. So we don't have to worry about pulling the magnet back out as you're catching your polarization tool. Again, make sure you push them in so they're all nice and flat. And sticking up will definitely ruin your day. And let me tell you, once these things are in, they ain't coming out. Anything short of destroying the part. Wipe off the existing. And that's it. There's my Razorback patch. Stays in there. There we go. You go nowhere. So, now, unfortunately, the Rhino hatch is a little trickier because it doesn't give you a nice flat surface to drill into. So this is what I have to do. Instead of drilling a hole, I'm going to take my hobby knife and cut a little U-shaped notch right next to the hinge. Right below what would be right below the hinge on the plastic. I kind of put the drill bit in an angle. Get it started. Just to clean out some of the extra material. And unfortunately what that means is that it's not going to be completely surrounded by plastic. So you need to be extra careful when gluing it in. So that's how we do stuff like that. I'll just do one real quick. Again, double check our polarity. All good. So we add some glue again. And again, the important thing here is to slide it off. This is going to be the hardest part, getting the magnet to stay in place as you remove the polarity tool. Step on back in there now. No, that's not good. So what you do, level it out. The magnet in the Rhino hatch. Now this does have to dry completely before you attempt to set it onto the body, otherwise the magnet will just come right off. So I'll save you the boring details of doing the other three sides, but that's it. That's how you magnetize a Rhino to a Razorback, or like they call it, the Rhino back.